Oh, it's hot, isn't it? It's a warm one. It's a Friday. It's 7:01 or something. 7:01, yes, it is. It's Friday, the 16th of July. Where has this year gone? Oh, that's right. It's gone in isolation. Week 67. We are indeed. We have five more quizzes for you this week. Two which I've stolen from last year because I like them. So we've got three general knowledge. Excuse me, the Smirnoff Ice is just a little bit gassy. Three general knowledge, one music cover up, so it's album covers. Just needed to tell me the name of the group or the band, and remote control madness. I sat on my remote earlier on and it's gone crazy. Anyway, if it's your birthday this week and you're too scared to say it, happy birthday. If it isn't, it will be soon. Quiz number one, 15 general knowledge questions to titivate the tonsils and the brain. Here we go, Bellwood Quizzes. Shabba, it's Friday. Here we go. To whom did Tina Turner duet on the 1990 single It Takes Two? So, who did Tina Turner do a duet with on 1990 single It Takes Two? Who was it? He's a sir, it's a fella, if that helps you. Probably not. Doesn't with me. Here we go. Number two. Which comedy duo's theme song was entitled Dance of the Cuckoos? So, which comedy duo's theme song was entitled Dance of the Cuckoos? There's quite a few of us around tonight. Question three. In which decade did Bonnie and Clyde go on their crime spree? So, in which decade did Bonnie and Clyde go on their crime spree? I think they did our local Witherspoons the other night. Oh, the machines were smashed, the naughty devils. Question number four. Which group released the 1998 song Mulder and Scully? So, which group released the 1998 song Mulder and Scully? Good evening, Dad and Mum. Good evening, Mandy from t'other side of the pond. Guy, Sankey, hello. Janice, good evening. Judith, hello. Shabba Stewart. Richard Dixon, hello. James from next door but one, hi. Hope you're okay. Jane and John, good evening. Just a few shout-outs. Here we go. Number five. Change and Shout were hits for which duo in the 1980s? Change and Shout were hits for which duo in the 1980s? Morecambe and Wise, was it? I don't know. And number six. What were the real surnames of Eric and Ernie? Do you remember that, Morecambe and Wise? Eric and Ernie, what were their real surnames? Tricky questions. Ouch. And question number seven, which US actress was presented with an honorary damehood by Queen Elizabeth II in 2014 for her anti-war campaigns? So, a US actress who got a damehood for anti-war campaigns in 2014. I think she married somebody very famous, didn't she? Number eight, Viking 1 landed on which planet in 1976? Oh, it's a nice chocolate bar, that. Viking 1 landed on which planet in 1976? Was that a big hint? I don't know. Aren't these nasty questions? Question 9. James Dean Bradfield is the frontman for which band? So, James Dean Bradfield is the frontman for which band? Aren't these horrible questions? We love it. And question number 10. What type of creature is a lilac-breasted roller? So what type of creature is a lilac-breasted roller? Not a clue. Here we go, number 11. Diane Murray, played by Bernie Nolan, was a character in which long-running series? Diane Murray? Not a clue. Played by Bernie Nolan. I think that's one of the Nolan sisters. Was a character in which long-running series? Is somebody getting buried under a patio? Oh, I don't know. Number 12. The series A Touch of Frost was set in which fictional town? So the series A Touch of Frost was set in which fictional town? Tell you what, I've not a clue on any of these. Not one of them. Number 13, in which decade was the TV series Prime Suspect first aired? So in which decade was the TV series Prime Suspect first aired? I think we'll give points away if you're anywhere near any of these tonight. And question 14, DS Justin Ripley, played by Warren Brown, was a character in which series? So DS Justin Ripley, I think it's police, isn't it? Played by Warren Brown, was a character in which series? Oh, dead easy. 14 out of 14 so far. Here's number 15, the highest mountain in the Alps is Mont Blanc. Is it how high to the nearest 1,000 meters? That didn't make sense. How high to the nearest thousand meters? Okay, Mont Blanc. How high to the nearest 1,000 meters? I could have put that really good. So how is Mont Blanc to the nearest 1,000 meters? Not feet, but meters. Not very nice, those, were they? They were not very nice at all. Let's mark it and we can just move on. So question one, to whom did Tina Turner duet in the 1990 single It Takes Two? That was Sir Rod Stewart. And number two, which comedy duo's theme song was entitled Dance of the Cuckoos? I wonder if anybody got that one. That was Laurel and Hardy. Three, in which decade did Bonnie and Clyde go to on their crime spree? If you're a decade either side, you can have a point. Well, even two, I don't care. 1930s. Number four, which group released the 1998 song Mulder and Scully? That was Catatonia. Change and Shout were hits for which duo in the 1980s? Was Tears for Fears? It was Change, wasn't it? Yeah. Number six, what were the real surnames of Eric and Ernie? It was Bartholomew and Wiseman. Bartholomew and Wiseman. Didn't know that. Seven, which US actress was presented with an honorary damehood by Queen Elizabeth II in 2014 for her anti-war campaigns? That was Angelina Jolie. Number eight, it's crazy. Viking 1 landed on the planet, but which planet in 1976? It was Mars. Number nine, James Dean Bradfield is the frontman for which band? That's the Manic Street Preachers. 10, what type of creature is a lilac-breasted roller? It's a bird, of course. It's either a bird or a fish, as Tony said the other week, and he's right. Diane Murray, played by Bernie Nolan, was a character in which long-running series? That was Brookside. And number 12, A Touch of Frost is set in which fictional town? That's Denton. Would never have known that. 13, in which decade was the TV series Prime Suspect first aired? So if you're a decade either side, you can have a point. It was the 1990s. DS Justin Ripley, played by Warren Brown, was a character in which TV series? That was Luther. And number 15, the highest mountain in the Alps is Mont Blanc, but how high is it to the nearest 1,000 metres? If you're 1,000 metres either side, you can have a point. It's 4,810, so the answer is 5,000 metres. Dead easy, isn't it? So tot up your score out of 15. Please don't be embarrassed if you only got one. They were nasty, nasty questions, weren't they? They were horribly nasty. Have a quick drink while we wait. There we go. So somebody's got five. I don't know who you are. There's a link when we just put the quiz online at the bottom that just gives you permission so I can use your name and your picture. Janice with a seven, yes. To the side of Pond, good morning, good morning. A very lucky seven, absolutely. Somebody else with a seven. If you just want to pop your name on, who you are, Facebook user with a seven, that'd be lovely. And happy birthday to me. Good start. The older the better, Brian. Well, you should know. You should know, James, but I agree with you, absolutely. Dad, a little four, that's all right. Stuart, a pooey nine, that's okay. Tom, six for me and Rachel. Well done, Tom. You're smashing it. Come on. Sophie, 10. It's not a poo 10, it's a good 10. Kathy with a 12. Please stop playing the piano. I'm sorry, guy. I'm sorry. It's with my feet as well. Yeah, amazing. Richard with an 8. Jane and John with a 10. Where's it going tonight? Who knows? Judith with a 4. Oh, dear. It's well done. June, good evening. A 10 out of 50. So there we go. So James, it is your birthday today. Thank you for reminding me. You know what we do when it's people's birthdays? James, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
There we go. Happy birthday. We had a cake and everything, but with the heat, it just didn't last. I'm sorry. So we had to eat it. Oh, dear. Anyway, have a nice evening out in the garden. I'll be able to hear your heckles later on. May even get a tune or two on the jukebox. Let's crack on anyway. Quiz number two. Another 15 amazing questions this week. How do we get these questions and where do we get them from? I'm not going to tell you. It's a secret, but they are getting worse, aren't they? Here we go. Quiz number two, Bellwood Quizzes. Let's roll. And you think all this is just made up off the top of our heads. You must be joking. Here we go. Which European football club plays its home games at the Philips Stadium? So which European football club plays its home games at the Philips Stadium? Oh, Rob and Sue are out for a meal tonight for Rob's 60th today. Rob, we will play a song for you in a minute. Good God, they're coming out of the woodwork. Number two, what was the title of Whitney Houston's first UK number one? I don't think it was that. What was the title of Whitney Houston's first UK number one? Oh, she was saving something, apparently. There we go, if that helps. Question number three. Which US state has Olympia as its capital? So which US state has Olympia as its capital? Google that one. And number four, the ecamm Stadium, shared by a football club and a rugby league club, is in which city? It's in the UK. The ecamm Stadium, shared by a football club and a rugby league club, is in which city? Question four. And question number five, what colour t-shirts does Shaggy wear in the Scooby-Doo TV series? Now, these are the sort of questions we want in the quiz. So what colour t-shirt does Shaggy wear in the Scooby-Doo TV series? This is brilliant. Think of a colour and write it down. If you get it wrong, just make it up. Everybody else does. And here's number six. What colour is Delph wear? So what colour is Delph wear? Is there a clue in the question? I don't know. No, there isn't actually. So what colour is Delph wear? Can't give you any clues on that one, really. Have to Google it. And number seven, what colour is the Air Berlin logo? So it's an airline. So what colour is the Air Berlin logo? Love these questions. They're so random, aren't they? So think of a colour. Any colour will do. Ooh, have you cut yourself? Ooh, that blood looks a bit red, doesn't it? So anyway, what colour is the Air Berlin logo? Number 8. In a game of pool, what colour is the 8 ball? So in the game of pool, what colour is the 8 ball? Best question of the night. Hookers and Hunter are shades of which colour? You need this when you're going to B&Q, don't you? You know, Hookers and Hunter, please. I'll have two tins, thank you. Hookers and Hunter are shades of which colour? I think Kev's painted his lounge in Hookers. There we go. Say no more. Number 10. What colour are the crescent and star on the flag of Algeria? How are we meant to know this? So what colour are the crescent and star on the flag of Algeria? Someday I will release my sources where I get these questions from, but not yet. In which decade was One Foot in the Grave first broadcast? So in which decade was One Foot in the Grave first broadcast? Good old Victor Meldrew. I think I live next door to them. I can hear the laughter already. Media City UK is located in which English city? So Media City UK is located in which English city? It's where all the BBC and stuff does all its really bad morning television really great TV shows from, isn't it? So in which English city? And number 13, what type of creature is a glass wing? So what type of creature is a glass wing? Not a clue. Well, I do actually, I know that one. Only because I've seen the answers. Yeah, right, do I know that one? Number 14, the Rocky Mountains stretch from British Columbia in Canada to which US state? So the Rocky Mountains stretch from British Columbia in Canada to which US state? Get your map out quick. And one more to go, the T-Banner. Is the name given to the underground rail system in which capital city? The T-Banner is the name given to which underground rail system in which capital city? I took my mum and dad there once for a day trip. There we go. Just in the back garden now, it just, you know, goes on onto the, it's quite nice, isn't it? We've got a lovely little view there, nice pond in the back garden, a couple of fish in there. Anyway, quiz number 2, which European football club plays its home games at the Philips Stadium? That's PSV Eindhoven. Wouldn't have known that one. And number 2, what's the title of Whitney Houston's first UK number 1? Saving All My Love For You. Thank you. Number 3, which US state has Olympia as its capital? Apparently that's Washington. Would never have guessed that, never at all. 4, the KCOM Stadium, shared by a football club and a rugby league club, is in which city? Apparently that's in Hull. There we go. Number 5, what colour T-shirt does Shaggy wear in the Scooby-Doo series? Did anybody get this without Googling it, looking it up or cheating? It was green, I wonder. There we go. Number 6, what colour is Delph wear? That's blue. 7, what colour is the Air Berlin logo? That's red. Number 8, in a game of pool, what colour is the 8 ball? That's black. Number 9, hookers and hunters are shades of which colour? It's green. Yeah, there we go. Number 10, what colour are the crescent and flag, the crescent and the star on the flag of Algeria? That's red. 11, in which decade was One Foot in the Grave first broadcast? You have a point if you're a decade either side, it doesn't matter. It was the 1990s. Number 12, Media City is located in which English city? That's in Salford, Manchester. At 13, what type of creature is a glasswing? That's a butterfly. 14 already, the Rocky Mountains stretch from British Columbia in Canada to which US state? That's in New Mexico. And number 15, the T-Banner is the name given to the Underground Rail system in which capital city? That's in Stockholm. Some really horrible questions again. I don't apologise. It's just the way the cookie crumbles, isn't it? Let's see how you did. Don't be shy, it's all right. Nobody's looking. Sophie's put this there. She lives in Hindhoven. Well, there we go. I hope you got the question right. Otherwise, you're in trouble. Debbie Hickman, good evening, an 8, splendid score. Tom Wilson, 10, I hope there was no cheating there, Tom. Janice with an 8, Kathy with an 11. Thompson's, that's always going to stick that, isn't it now? Thompson's from t'other side of Bond. 10, well done, Michelle with a 10, splendid. Woohoo, Richard is a woohoo, absolutely, 10, well done. Jane, a consistent 10, absolutely. Wow. Oh, Stuart's getting worse. It's not getting worse. It's all right. Doesn't matter. Have another drink. A respectable 11, June. Absolutely it is. Guessed a couple of colours that... Well, you have to, James, don't you? There's no point in doing it otherwise. Oh, hello, Kevin. Good evening. Glad you could switch on, tune in, get your valves warmed up. A 5, that's all right. Mum, Dad, Brian, a double 8. Oh, well done. Yeah, that's good. Guy, a smiley 9, and Judith, ho ho ho, a happy 8. Oh, Sophie's just punged in. Wow. Yeah, absolute question 2 will have helped, but coming on again, Sophie, a 15. That's fantastic. Blimey, how many atlases and stuff do you have thrown out around the room for this, and how many electronic assistants? But well done, good scores. So just before we go for a little bit, Rob and Sue. Rob, I believe it's a monumentous birthday for you today. Happy birthday from everybody here at the Bellwood Quiz Emporium. You're going to get a hideous song just for you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
That's so cheesy, isn't it? It's great. Love it. Right, a quick 60-second break, just in time for you to just glug your glugs quick. We'll see you back in 60 clicks. Toodaloo. Good evening, Max. Doesn't matter you're joining late. You've got wine, that's the main thing. I got Smirnoff Ice, do you remember those? Might have a turbo shandy later on. Get in. Here we go, we're back. Ooh, that's a nice picture. No, floaty-like. Good evening and welcome to the people who just joined us. Max, hi. Anyway, music cover-up is the next one. We've done this quiz before. It was last year sometime, but I thought I'd pull it out of the bag because we like these. You're going to see 15 album covers, could be CD covers, but the name of the band, of course it is, it's going to be scribbled out, so you don't know who it is. I just need you to tell me the name of the group, the band, or the solo artist, whatever it is. Dead easy. Here we go. Music cover up. Come on. So, just name the band, just do what it says. Question number one. Kev, do you have a mask like that? Where you pretend to be like Batman and Superman up the street? Number two. She needs a bit of sunshine, doesn't she? She looks a bit pasty. Oof. She looks even worse now. So name the artist. Question number two. Number three. Mum and Dad at this point, go and have a drink. Come back in a few minutes. You'll not get any of these. No, you won't. You won't. I'm kidding yourself if you think I will. There's a question three. There we go. Name the band. And here's number four. She's had 2 weeks all-inclusive. Look at that suntan. It's bloody gorgeous, isn't it? But what was the name, or who is the name of the artist? Did she do Smooth Operator? Under a Red Sky. What have you been smoking? Name the band or the artist. But it's name the artist, because that's what it says there. So just scribble it down if you know who that is. Number six. James is painted up like that tonight, aren't you, for the quiz? Bottom right, I think that's you. Oh, it could be top right, actually. Here's number seven, name the band. What was the name of the band with that cover? Just realised that's a big socks, isn't it? Sock, isn't it? Karen, good evening. It's all right. Happy Friday. Sit down, relax. Enjoy the trip. And it is a trip. Question seven is the name the band. Here's number eight. Does anybody know that Random Access Memory was the name of that? But what was the name of the band? Tell you what, Karen, if you've got Tim with you, it'd be no good in this one. Number nine. Look at that belt. Get them in Primark now, I think, can't you? Ooh. But name the artist. Who is that? I think a few people will get good scores on this round, I think. There'll be a few people are getting on as well. It's a Crazy Sexy Cool. What was the name of that band? Question 10, are these getting harder now or not? I don't know. Number 11. Remember that? I used to see that in HMV all the time, but what was the name of the band? What was the name of the band that did that album? Question 11. Number 12. Mother-in-law without any make. Question 12. Name the band. She's going to kill me. She's going to kill me. And number 13. That could be an easy one, that, couldn't it? Crazy hairdo, isn't it? But name the band. Question 13. Two more to go after this. Can you brace yourselves? Question 14. Can you name that band? And number 15. Venus. What's the band called? Not the name of the band, it's the name of the song they did. I don't know how many of them are original cast members now. Well, how did we find album cover? Do we remember that from last time? I wonder if we do. Let's mark it anyway, and then we can go and have a little top up of our drinkies. So number one was the Eurythmics. Two was Madonna. Three was Coldplay. Number four was Whitney Houston. I wonder if anybody put Sade on that one. Five was Bob Dylan. Six was Kiss. Thank you. Seven, Oasis. Eight was Daft Punk. Number nine was Bruce Springsteen. 10, anybody get that one? TLC. I wonder what TLC stood for, I can't remember. 11 was Nirvana. 12 was Iron Maiden. Everybody has one in their house. 13 was Queen. 14 was Led Zeppelin. And number 15 was Bananarama. Of course it was. Tot up your scores. I think we could have a couple of 15ers here. And maybe the odd zero, Mum and Dad. So let's see how we did. Debbie, you're the first off the marks. Blimey, you've got quick fingers. With a 10. What a lovely score. Here we go, a few more coming. Tom, oh, Tom, only a 4. Blinking heck, man. It's all right, don't worry, put a 1 in front. To the side at Bondello with a 12. Isn't it amazing technology? At 15, yes, back of the net. Well done, Janice, with a 4. Boom. I will do the sound effects for you, Sophie. 15, well done, amazing. Perfect. Kathy with a 14. You enjoyed that round. I know, they're good fun, aren't they? Jane and John with an 11. You see, this is making people feel better. A bit euphoric, isn't it? 7 guy is all right. It's okay. Stuart with a 15. I'd be feeling better with a 15, Stuart. Absolutely. You're right. Yeah, coffee. Absolutely. He got 1. Oh, well done. I wonder which one that was. Come off it. Pull the birthday card out now, James. That's right. 8's a good score because Kev only got 11. There we go. Michelle with a 12. Yes. June, you couldn't remember TLC. I think, did they do waterfalls? Somebody mean, you know? I think they did waterfalls and that was about it, wasn't it? I can't remember what else they did. Judith with a 6, not getting any better. It will, Judith. It will get better. Dr. Brian is telling you it will get better. And Richard Dixon says, hello, Fentons. Hee hee hee. Gosh, we're like some sort of communication service, aren't we? It's ridiculous. Right, we're going for a full break now. We'll see you back in a few minutes. Top up your drinkies. Have a toilet break if you need one, Maxine. We'll not tell anybody. And we'll see you in a few minutes. Toodaloo. Bye for now. We'll be right back. Are we back? Sorry, I was just reading A Busy Person's Guide to Yoga. Oh, that's better. Anyway, welcome back, Bellwood Quizzers, to part two of this week's quiz. Another 15, general knowledge questions, and then we've got a nice quiz to end. So let's crack on with quiz number four. 15 questions. Here we go. Right, come on, Tom, you've got to beat your dad on this round. Here we go. James, get in. Here we go. Which retired golfer was nicknamed Supermex? So which retired golfer has been nicknamed Supermex? Ooh, James gonna know that one, or is Tom gonna know that one? Ooh, no conferring, come on. So question number one, which retired golfer has the nickname Supermex? So he's Mexican, if that helps. Number two, a wall is what type of tiny creature? A wall, W-A-L-L, a wall is what type of tiny creature? Oh, right, okay. There we go. Something that sits on a wall or sticks to a wall, that might help. And number three, in which decade were driving licenses first introduced into the UK? So in which decade were driving licenses first introduced into the UK? Obviously, we'll go 10, 20 years either side on that because it's a tricky one. So in which decade were driving licenses first introduced into UK? And number four, whose army famously sheltered under a banyan tree? So whose army famously sheltered under a banyan tree? Got one of them in the back garden. Anyway, here we go, let's move on. Number five, in Greek, or which Greek mathematician died in 212 BC? So which Greek mathematician, really famous mathematician, died in 212 BC? Was able to move water from one place to another, water up a pipe, if that helps. That gives you a name. Oh, it does. Come on, Tom, beat your dad. At number six, which artist painted the 1953 picture Funfair at Daisy Nook? Not Daisy Hill. Funfair at Daisy Nook. So which artist painted the 1953 picture Funfair at the Daisy Nook? It was a UK painter, if that helps. Northern UK painter as well. Seven, on what date is International Women's Day celebrated? Every day, somebody will say. On what date is International Women's Day celebrated? So glad the mother-in-law is not here. She clapped me around the head tonight. In fact, I don't think they're playing tonight. Oh, so I can tell you stories about it. No. Number eight, which TV competition did Brian Chesney win in 2018? So which TV competition did Brian Chesney win in 2018? Oh, I've started, so... Oh, did I not finish that? Sorry. Can't go back now. Number nine, what does a pedologist study? So what does a pedologist study? Or pedologist? Ooh, fly in here. So what does a pedologist study? Question number nine. Let's get back to that one. And question number 10. John Part is a famous name in which indoor sport? John Part. Ooh. Am I giving too many clues away this week? In which city? Sorry, I've just got a piece of ice in my mouth. In which city was Sir Frank Whittle, the inventor of the jet engine, born? So in which city, it's in England, was Sir Frank Whittle, the inventor of the jet engine, born? Question 11. It's some nasty questions in here, isn't there? Number 12, what's the capital city of Mauritius? What's the capital city of Mauritius? Is it Port something? I can't remember what it is. Give me a help, it's Port something, I'm sure it is. Could be wrong. So number 12, the capital city of Mauritius. I wrote the bloody questions and I can't remember the answers. And here we go with number 13. Ben Lear and Early Black are varieties of what fruit? So Ben Lear and Early Black are varieties of what fruit? Hey James, I bet Tom's cheating on these. Number 14, what was the name of Guy Pearce's character in the TV series Neighbours? So what was the name of Guy Pearce's character in the TV series Neighbours? You bloody galah. And here we go, number 15. To the nearest meter, how high is the Great Pyramid of Giza? So to the nearest meter, how high is the Great Pyramid of Giza? We'll have a bit of leeway on that one, I think, won't we? But there we go. What's the nearest meter of the Great Pyramid? Who knows? I can spin round tonight. Look. Ooh. And I better not do that. Ooh, feels a bit sick. Ooh. Anyway, there we go. Which retired golfer has the nickname Supermex? That was Lee Trevino. Anybody get that one? It's a tricky one, that. Number 2, a wall is what type of tiny creature? That's a butterfly. Number 3, in which decade were driving licences first introduced into the UK? If you... 22 decades either side, you can have a point. It was the 1900s, 1903, believe it or not. Amazing, that, isn't it? Number 4, whose army famously sheltered under the banyan tree? Apparently that was Alexander the Great. At number 5, which Greek mathematician died in 2012 BC? That was Archimedes. Archimedes screw. I gave you the answer, didn't I? At number 6, which artist painted the 1953 picture The Funfair at Daisy Nook? That was L.S. Lowry. And number 7, on what date is International Women's Day celebrated? That's the 8th of March. It's everything, it's in my diary. Number 8, which TV competition did Brian Chesney win in 2018? Beep, beep, I've started so I'll finish. Mastermind. Number 9, what does a pedologist study? That's soil. I would have thought that was feet. I'm joking. Number 10, John Part is a famous name in which indoor sports? Darts. 11, in which city did Sir Frank Whittle, the inventor of the jet engine, was born? Great quiz question, this, for a pub, isn't it? That was Coventry. You'll know it when it comes up. You go, I know that one. 12, what's the capital of Mauritius? I knew it was Port something. Port Louis or Louis. Port Louis. 13, Ben Lear and Early Black are varieties of which fruit? Anybody get this one? The cranberry. I would never have got that one. I'd have probably said pear or something like that, but cranberry is the answer, apparently. 14, what was the name of Guy Pearce's character in the TV show Neighbours? Mike Young. And number 15, to the nearest meter, how high is the Great Pyramid of Giza? What should we do? 20 meters either side? Yeah, 20 meters either side. And the height is 147 meters. Ooh, I've climbed it numerous times. Toss up your score out of 15 and let's see how you did. We've got Remote Control Madness coming up. Oh, I nearly dropped my drink. So then, I wonder, did Tom or James get a higher score? This is, you know, proper family rivalry. This is what we like. Debbie's got a load of monkeys with a 4. Don't worry, Debbie, it's just for fun. Nobody's marking it. You don't have to send your score sheets in or anything. That would be good, wouldn't it? Michelle, 6. It's all right. There were some nasty questions there. Janice with a 6. International Women's Day should be February the 20th. I'll put it up again. You're in trouble there. Good score, James. A 9. Sophie, it's all right. 9's okay. Ooh, Stuart. Okay, we'll move on. Steady sit. Dad, you beat Stuart. He only got a 5. Dad, you got a 6. Well done. Oh, Mandy only got a 4. Oh, Mandy. Oh. Is it too early for... No, it's never too early for a glass of wine, is it? It's Friday. You've had a busy week, help yourself. Richard with a 5. Oh, gosh. Tom with a 6. Your dad beat you, Tom, with a 9. He's cheating. He must be. Go and spy on him. Guy with a terrible 5. The Oslo scores with nasty questions. Kathy with a 6. 7. Well done, Alexa. I mean, Kev, well done. Jane and John a 10. That's a best score. 1 and 2. Well, exactly, Karen. That's the problem. Tim's helping you tonight. Ooh, he's always in the way if he's out with a tray. Is that a phantom on 14F? Are we starting that again? I wonder if James has a Google. I think you're right, Tom. I think he has. I think he's cheating. I have to peer over the fence and watch. Not like that. Judith with a 10. And June with a 5. It doesn't matter. It's just for fun. So, the office now. I'm doing some work. Last quiz of the night. Remote control madness. So you're going to see 15 pop videos. I need you to give me the name of the artist or group and the name of the song for a point. If you only get one bit right, you get half a point. It's easy as that. So if we're ready for remote controlled madness, here we go. I tell you what, Tom, let's see how your dad does on this one. Here we go. Number 1, name the artist and the song. Sat on my remote control. That VHS tape's going bad. So that's number 1. Here's number 2. The name of the artist and the song. What a boring video. Here's number 3. Get this one, come on, James. He was singing to this one a few years ago. So give me the name of the band and the song. Here's the next one. Sound any different, to be honest? The artist and the song. Come on, Dad, come put the kettle on. I wish you'd give me her wig back. Good one, isn't it? You don't get the artist and the name of the song for a full point. Here we go. This is filmed in the Bellwood Studios, this one. Does anybody remember this one? So again, the name of the group or the artist. I'll give you a clue, it's an artist if you don't know. And the name of the song. Easy one, I think, this. Lynn with a fascinator. What's the name of the artist and the song? James on his birthday down the street, showing off to all the streets of Bellwood. I didn't realise you had an earring though. The best one ever, this. Styles there. I think this is an easy one. Must be an easy one, this one. What's the name of the song? Tom, I think you play this one in your car, isn't it? Easy one. I think this, come on, everybody will get this one. But what's the name of the song? Tony in his white polo neck. There's Kev with his hair. Whoa, is that me? Oh, fabulous remote control madness. Don't you just love it? It's madness. Oh, I'd say we did that quiz last year. I made that one last year. And I love the George Michael one. I thought it was hilarious. Anyway, here we go. Anyway, it was Wham, wasn't it? Let's rock remote control madness. I mean, Debbie's probably still howling with laughter. Come on, breathe, Debbie. Come on, bring it back. Come on, bring it back. I got the word. No, I can't say. Anyway, number one, George Michael and Fast Love was that. Number two, Natalie and Brulia and Torn. Number three was Aha and Take On Me. Four, Stardust, Music Sounds Better With You. Number five, it certainly does. Vanilla Ice and Ice Ice Baby. Why did they do that for that? I don't know. Number six, Simply Red and Stars. Seven, Tina Turner. What's Love Got to Do with It? Eight was Will Smith and Miami. Nine, easy one, Madonna, Into the Groove. Get the band dead easy. But do you remember the song, isn't it? That's a tricky bit. Ten, Justin Timberlake and Rock Your Body. 11, Missy Elliott and Work It. 12, Whitney Houston, I Want to Dance with Somebody. 13, Cher, Believe. 14, James, it was you in that video. Right Said Fred and I'm Too Sexy. And number 15 was Wham and Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go. I should Coco. Anyway, tot up your score out of 15. Don't forget, if you only get half of it right, half a point, doesn't matter anyway. Tot your score out at 75. And pop that on there. Let's see how you did this week for week 67. So, Dad, didn't you do a total of zero? I thought you would. I'd be amazed if you got any of those right. You might have got Michael Jackson probably and Tina Turner, but there we go. There we go. What about the other five that didn't get answers for? What about the other five we didn't get answers for? We did, didn't we? We did 15 answers, I'm sure we did. We did, I'm sure. Let's carry on anyway. Debbie Hitman got a 13. I wonder if your internet just had a blip then. Oh, there were 20, were there? Oh, I don't know. I did it ages ago. Well, I don't know, I've only got for 15. Just add another 5 onto your score. I don't know what's going on. Did you go to the pub? I think I did, yeah. Tom with a 7, Karen with a 9.5. That's messed it up because I can't really find the answers anywhere else. But there we go. Michelle with a 13. Oops, what a blunder. Kev with 21. There were 20, Michelle. Apparently there were. Yeah, 13.5 for Stuart. Sophie with a 20. I don't know how we've done that. I don't know anyway. James missed that round. He's a visitor. Oh, okay. Jane John, yeah, I know there were 20 questions. I know. Look, once in 68 weeks, I've made a mistake. There we go. June with 11.5. Well done, June. Jane and John gives you a 51 out of 75. I don't know, Jeff. Nor do I. Not at all. Yeah, I know. I'm not saying any more. 26 total 55. Guy, you're welcome. Perhaps we might get a quiz that we can do right next week. I really don't know. Who knows? Have we got any more scores coming through? We have. You marked on my side. Well, I would mandate. Do you know what? I think you could probably do a better job than me, actually. Is that Smirnoff ice I'm blaming? 17 out of 20. Well done. You got 15, but the real. I don't know. I don't know what's going on there. Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah. Just make it 15. 40 out of 75, Debbie. You're welcome. 48. Oh, what a blunder I've made this week. Sophie, 17.5 out of 20. That's a good one for that. 4.5, 32. What happened to Michael Jackson, Queen and the Bee Gees? I don't know. Let me just see if it's on my list. I've obviously not put them down. I really don't know. Right, said Fred. Wham. Yeah, I've missed them off my answers. What a silly buffoon I am. Absolutely, Mandy. I think that's the note to self. No Smirnoff ice when writing the quiz. 65.5 out of 80. Sophie, well done. Tom with a 33. Let's move on quick and say goodnight. Kathy, you're welcome. We'll try and get it right one of these weeks, won't we? But it just doesn't matter. Janice with a 32 plus. Give yourself 40. Ooh, Richard, that's an idea. Oof. So, I think I'll go back to, it all started when I started my yoga, I think. I think that's been, how can you get in? I don't know which way that is. Anyway, thank you for playing. We'll try and get it right next week. I have no idea what's gone on there, but it just doesn't matter. It's only for fun. And if you got the other five right, well done. You've done a bonus. Fabulous. We will see you next week for quiz 68. I will try and write a quiz correctly for once in 68 weeks. Oops. Please stay safe because Monday the whole world goes back to normality. Yep. And then in 3 weeks' time, we're back in a lockdown. No, I'm only joking. Please stay safe out there. And we will see you next week from somewhere. God knows where. Was going to be the Balearics. Don't think it's going to be them. But anyway, look after yourselves and each other. One word. Shabba.